That was a total surprise. Thank you. Before I begin, I have a private message that I'd like to give to someone in the audience. Everyone, close your ears. To my wonderful, adorable, fantastic husband, Norman, I thank you for being my partner, my best friend, my lover, my confidant, my sidekick, and everything else thrown together for over 40 years. I thank my children for being here. I couldn't have done this without the three of you sitting here, so thank you very much. And now, Matt, I'd like to thank you for that beautiful introduction and to thank all of you here for your warmth and confidence in welcoming me as chair of our Federation's Board of Directors. A year ago, I accepted the new chair designate position with my eyes opened, my heart full, and the nerves of steel that some people are surprised to find underlying my genuinely calm and caring demeanor. Tonight, I stand before you with pride and excitement as we take the next steps together on our Federation's journey. And while you've seen me steadily preparing over the past year, my path to leading our Federation began about four decades ago in a little townhouse in the Chicago suburbs, when a cash-strapped young couple at the very edge of losing everything after sinking all they had and a lot more into their business, turned to each other and made a promise. Feeling that deep, gut-wrenching hurt and fear of how the bills would get paid, of what would happen to us and our children, Norman and I made a promise to each other. With the odds far, far against us, that if things turned around, we would do whatever we could to ensure that others facing such adversities would have comfort, food, shelter, and home for the future, knowing they were not alone. And as you most of you know, that business did turn around. It became successful beyond our imagination. And our dreams turned in earnest to fulfilling that promise of helping others. But I could never forget the power of that feeling of scarcity and dread. It resonates deep inside of me when I feel it among others in need. So you see, for me, what we do here at our Federation is personal. I see my job first and foremost in terms of what we mean to the people we help, those who are still waiting around the corner for help, and those who will need us in the future. My philanthropic journey may have begun in Chicago, but my path to leadership was paved right here in South Palm Beach County more than 20 years ago. We were still snowbirds in the process of making this our home in this community when one day I picked up the telephone, made a phone call to the Federation, and I said, I want to be a lion. Without actually looking, I had found a true home and then a calling in women's philanthropy. I realized how much more I could do for our community and our people if I jumped in with both feet. So, with our women's support and their encouragement, I learned, I grew, and I took that leap into leadership. My Jewish family and my Jewish heart kept growing as I learned more and more about the people who depend upon us, from down the street to across the globe. I have seen the fragility of Jewish life and the comfort, hope, and joy our work brings to so many in a myriad of ways. Always feeling those needs so deeply beyond our annual campaign, I've responded to causes from the waiting list for home assistance for our Holocaust survivors, to emergency relief for Israelis under siege, to help launch our PJ library, to the need for a full-time rabbi for our college students at Hillel. Perhaps it was these experiences or watching my two grandchildren growing up in this community, but over time, I found myself more and more concerned about how our Federation would be able to take care of our people in the years ahead. How would we respond to those needs we might predict, as well as others that emerged either suddenly or over time? Norman and I named the foundation with a wonderful endowment, and our sense of relief and accomplishment has been overwhelming. My commitment to our future remains at the very core of my work at Federation. Always hands-on, learning and connecting, I return from each personal experience with a fire burning with pride inside of me in the amazing organization and our Jewish community, whether laughing with young children while reading to them at a PJ Library event, or tearing up at my first visit to Torah Academy, or getting goosebumps watching Rabbi Brody put mezuzot on the doorposts of our new neighbors at Sinai Residences, or with my heart bursting as so many different groups donate and package groceries at our food pantry. Those of us with the courage to care deeply are drawn to this Federation because here the pieces all come together. No other organization has Federation's capacity to be where and when our Jewish people need us. And no other organization can bring us all together as a community to hear and learn from each other and accomplish miracles together. We have taken leaps in the past few years to bring our Jewish community together. As Matt has said, our coming together across the usual boundaries of Jewish life is extraordinary. Our Federation, our agencies, our synagogues do not stand alone. We in this room know that we're in this together. And now, it's time to get to work. I am deeply grateful for Al's leadership that has brought us to this bright point on our Federation's timeline. Al, I know I can never fill your shoes, but I do have my own size and my own style. If I had to pick one goal for my tenure, it would be to make others feel the passion that I have, to ensure that no one is left out, from our very youngest to our very oldest. As I take my place at the head of the Federation table, there will always be more seats for those who want to help build and strengthen this Jewish community. I ask you, all of you, to join me in sharing these opportunities with others so they too can experience the powerful rewards of connection and the joy of knowing they've made a difference. Thank you all very much.